The new 12 Intel generation was announced, and with it, the new Z690 motherboard. On today, we'll be looking at a new Asus PRIME Z690-P D4 motherboard designed for new 12th generation Intel CPU. Good morning and welcome to Tech Interceptor. First of all, remember to subscribe to the channel and activate the notification bell to stay up to date on upcoming videos. As anticipated to begin, in this new first contact, we are going to discover the new Z690-P D4, which joined the family of numerous Z690 motherboard produced by Taiwanese company. You can find the complete run-up list of the new board in the description below. Starting from the box, we find, of course, the motherboard, two SATA 6 GB/s cable, shield for back IO panel, one M2 rubber package, two M2 SSD screw package, the support DVD and the user manual. The new Asus PRIME Z690-P D4 is an 80x form factor motherboard that measures 30.5 cm for 23.4 cm. The board presented a VRM layout feature 14+1 DR MOS deliver the power and efficiency with low RDS MOSFET. It is covered by two massive VRM silver brush heatsink with high quality thermal pad at the upside and at the near the IO back panel. In addition, there is another that covers the M2 slot. As all new Z690 boards, it features Intel LGA1700 socket that support the 12th generation Intel Core i9, i7, i5, i3, Intel Pentium Gold and Intel Celeron CPUs. The motherboard is equipped with 4 DDR4 DIMM sockets dual channel memory architecture that support 32 GB single DIMM capacity up to a maximum to 128 GB for 4 DIMM. It supports DDR4 from 2133 MHz to 3200 MHz and to 5333 in overclocking. Regarding the header of the motherboard, in the upside from the left, there are 4 and 8 pin ATX 12 volt power connector for your CPU and the 2 CPU fan header. Going down on the right side, there are Aura RGB header, addressable Gen 2 header, chassis fan header, 24 pin ATX main power socket, USB 3.2 Gen 1 header, USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-C header, front panel connector, SPI, TPM or Trusted Platform Module header. In the bottom of Asus motherboard, there are two addressable Gen 2 header, 4 SATA 6 GB/s header, system panel header, USB 3.2 Gen 1 header, two USB 2 header, clear CMOS header, Thunderbolt header, chassis fan header, COM port header, front panel audio header, and in the middle the IO pump fan header. Storage option includes 4 SATA 3 port and 3 M2 slot. 2 M2 slot that support type 2242, 2260, 2280, 22110 SATA and the PCI Express 4.044 mode M2 SSD. There is also another M2 connector supporting type 2242, 2260, 2280, PCI Express 4.044 mode SSD. The motherboard feature expansion slot 1 PCI Express 5.0, 4.0 and 3.0 for 16 slot. one PCI Express 4.0 3.0 for 16 slot support for 4 mode, 2 PCI Express 3.0 for 16 slot support for 4 mode, and 1 PCI Express 3.0 for 1 slot. On back via IO panel we find the firstly PS2 keyboard mouse combo port, 2 USB 2.0 port, display port, HDMI port, USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type A port, USB 3.2 Gen Type C port, Realtek 2.5GB Ethernet port, 2 USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type A ports, optical SPDIF out port, and 7.1 point channel audio with audio jacks including center subwoofer speaker out, rear speaker out, side speaker out, front speaker out, and mic in. And now we talk about of prices. The motherboard will be available from November 4 on retail at price of about $220 at the time of making this video. And you, what do you think? Let me know as always in the comments below, and if you find this video helpful then leave a like, share it and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching, see you again next time.